Last time, we explored how AutoGen agents can search the web and comment within a group shed. Today, we'll discover how to make these results available to web applications through a REST interface. Let's pick up right where we left off in our last session. We'll use Flask for this, starting with the necessary imports. This involves importing Flask along with JSONify, request, and render templates. Next, we create a new app instance. We then add a command to run this app, specifically on port 8080. We'll now create an endpoint to serve a web page from the root directory. We set up an index method and use render template to display an index HTML page. To serve this, it must be placed in a templates directory, which we'll create now. Inside the templates directory, we'll create an index HTML file. Initially, we'll add a simple hello world to test if everything functions correctly. Let's start the server now to check if everything's set up properly. Great, our hello world is successfully displayed on localhost. Next, we aim to start our group chat through the web page. We'll define a new run root with a corresponding method, accessing the get parameter stock. We do this by accessing request args.getStock. This parameter allows us to dynamically conduct our stock price search. We can easily incorporate the stock name into our message using straightforward string interpolation. Next, we'll store the group chat results in a variable to return as JSON. We retrieve the conversation history from the user proxy. And finally, we return the result as JSON. Now let's test if the endpoint is functional. We'll use curl to test both endpoints with a simple call. First, we test the index and it returns successfully. Then we try it with a stock parameter, specifying the value shown in the video. Looking at the other console, we can see the group chat has successfully started. However, there's a small error we need to quickly fix. It seems that the stock name parameter isn't being utilized correctly in the code. All right, it appears we've missed the letter F in front of the string, which is why the string interpolation isn't functioning. Let's try it again. Okay, now everything works as expected. Now let's enhance our website to enable starting the group chat directly from it. I've prepped a small website that mimics our curl requests functionality. It features a simple input field for entering names. Clicking the button triggers a JavaScript function that fetches the run endpoint. All right, let's test our new index page. Testing the new setup, we find everything works flawlessly. However, we notice the spec end awaits input from the user proxy, which in turn waits for user input. Our goal, though, is to eliminate the need for user input. To achieve this, we need to modify the human input mode. But first, we must define when a conversation is considered complete. We can set the isTermination message in the user proxy so the conversation ends when a participant says terminate. Next, we change the human input mode to open, ensuring the user proxy never seeks feedback from the real user. All right, let's run a test to see if the agents will now engage in a chat seamlessly without any interruptions. Okay, it works. We've successfully found a way to initiate group chats through the endpoint, and if all goes well, display the results on the front end. If you found this walkthrough helpful and you're keen to dive deeper into the world of AutoGen and group chats, remember to hit that like button, subscribe for more content, and share your thoughts in the comments below. Your support helps us bring more tutorials like this to you.